Hey there, it's Andre here. Do you by any chance believe that moving out of the city and going north, and I mean way, way north, is a great way to get yourself some land? Maybe get more house for your buck, potentially escape the crazy real estate market of late 2020, and get yourself into a fair real estate deal? Well, what can I say? It's time to stop believing in fairy tales because Collingwood, a seemingly quiet town in prior balanced market, is now sold. All jokes aside, the title and thumbnail are correct and not clickbait. In this video, we're gonna talk about how Collingwood is now being dubbed the new Oakville of the North, if you may, and in my opinion, why this subject property that we're gonna look at today ended up getting 23 offers and selling for a record high price in terms of Collingwood sales. If you're new here, what's up? My name's Andre, Canada's youngest realtor. It's down there somewhere. I make real estate content like this, and please consider subscribing because I would love to start putting non-skippable ads every 10 seconds in my videos. And if you want to skip ahead to where I talk about the 23 offers and final sale price, it's also down in the time code below. Okay, so the Collingwood real estate market is on total fire right now. And in my opinion, a big part of that has to do with buyers coming up from the major cities down south, like Toronto, Mississauga, Etobicoke, and Oakville. Arguably, with a little bit of money in their pocket after selling their 3-bedroom townhouses for, I don't know, over $1 million. And they're seeing Collingwood as the higher end community and neighborhood of the north. Now, obviously the location is beautiful and has an impact on this as well. You have the lake, the mountains, plenty of room to build and so on, but just the name Collingwood seems to attract people. Now, my take on it is this. How many people honestly live in Toronto just to say they're from Toronto? And maybe you have friends or know people that live in Etobicoke or North York technically, but still say they're from Toronto. And I think that's totally fine. A lot of these individuals are selling childhood or downtown properties with the intention of buying their dream home up north. Because in Simcoe, prices are better. You're gonna get more house for your money than you would for the same amount in the GTA. And in the whole process of finding and buying your dream house, why not go all the way and just get a neighborhood name upgrade as well? The fact of the matter is that I've personally spoken to agents who have flat out said their clients are shopping in Collingwood specifically because of the name and the perceived status that it holds. I'd even go so far as to say that if Collingwood, the exact area of Collingwood, was named something like Feversham, this property would not have sold for what it sold for. So if we were to divide it up by my standards here, I'd say it's about 60 to 75% name, 25 to 45% location as to why the Collingwood real estate market is so hot right now and why we're not just seeing multiple offers, not multiple offers, but double digit offers on a location, a neighborhood that is over 2 hours away from Toronto and other major cities. And keep in mind, we're talking about an area that gets 3 feet of snow on the regular, right? Like in Barrie, we get a lot of snow. In Toronto, you get almost no snow. In Collingwood, I can't even imagine the winters they have up there. Even saying Oakville of the North just sounds cool to me. Like try saying Barrie, the Mississauga of the North, or Orillia, the Etobicoke of the North. It doesn't flow, it doesn't sound nice. But when you say Collingwood, the Oakville of the North, it just flows. It just sounds good. Now let's talk about this property and you can see for yourself and decide whether or not it was worth the number of offers that it had and maybe, you know, was it worth the final sale price that it eventually ended up getting. So starting off with the exterior here, the exterior is actually not bad. It's well kept, you know. From the outside you say, you know what, like this could be a nice house, but wait, when you get inside, that's really where the magic starts coming up. So the first photo here, boom, living room. You know, obviously updated, very contemporary, earthy tones, you know, that's coming back in. The carpet looks stellar. You know, I'm not even gonna try and be funny. It's very dated, right? Like you look through these photos and you're like, oh my, like 23 offers? Like, are you shitting me? Like, no way. I mean, like, look at this. Like the basement is like 6 feet tall. Like I had to lean down when walking through it. So it's not even considered a full basement. You know, it's got a bar, which is cool, but yeah. This is it. 23 offers. Let me know in the comments below if you think it's worth it. So we ended up driving in Collingwood and showing this property. The clients did like it and they did put an offer over asking within that 515 to 550 range because they saw the potential in it and we told them about the market in the area as well. And that is when the first email came in. So the first email just said 3 offers, right? And first impressions, that's not bad. We offered over asking on a property that needed, you know, extensive amount of work. We're in competition, but not something that we weren't expecting on a property like this. They were presenting at 5 or 6 p.m. So we had the offer in, there were 3 offers, we were ready for it, and we were just waiting for an answer back. 2.5 hours later, 6 offers. So pretty cool. The number of offers doubled in 3 hours. Slim chance that we would get it, but maybe still a small chance, you know, given the state of the property and the condition it was in. Minutes following that 6 offers email, we get another email saying that there's now 13 offers on the property. Cool. Now we're in double digits. Very slim chance we're gonna get it, but you know what? Good for the seller. It's good for the seller. Maybe they deserve it. Maybe it's their lucky day or their lucky season, their lucky week. Now keep in mind how it usually works with these paging systems is that as soon as you show the property, your contact information gets saved and every single agent is notified when an offer comes in. Now seeing as there was a presentation date on this property, every agent that showed it within the 5 business day period, they were getting pages letting them know how many offers were on the property. And lo and behold, 40 minutes following that email at 6:11 p.m. at night, we got an email saying that there's 23 offers. Okay, and keep in mind, again, this is north of Toronto where you are getting a crazy amount of snowfall. 2 hours north of Toronto in a neighborhood, we are in competition on a property that has 23 offers on it. And the moment that you've been waiting for and the number that you've been wanting to hear, this property was listed at a whopping $499,000 and sold that day, 23 offers later, for $625,000 firm. No conditions, done deal, no inspections, no financing. Hell, there could be like a sizable leak in the foundation. Done deal, 625K cash. Now, if you're still with me here, there's a little bit of a twist to this story. This is a partial example of, again, how hot the Collingwood market is. You know, it shows that a property that has 23 offers, again, 2 hours north of Toronto, sold for $125,000 firm over asking price. Now, the twist here being is that I believe it was a Toronto buyer that bought this. Now the cooperating brokerage is local. It was an agent in Collingwood that helped this client buy the property. I think it was a referral or someone that, you know, wanted to use a local agent, as a lot of Toronto agents don't want to drive 2 hours there, 2 hours back just for one showing in Collingwood. But I think the twist here being that this is an incredible opportunity and that we're probably going to see this property hit the market again in a couple months, fully renovated and fully redone. It makes pretty good sense. For $625,000, you can buy quite a bit in the surrounding area and in Collingwood as well. And if you're shopping for your dream home, why would you buy something like this? I believe going forward into 2021, Collingwood is still going to be experiencing this growth because of the buyers pushing up from the south and because, you know, they're regarding Collingwood as a high-end neighborhood, which it is, and it has a lot to offer. In that sense. So I think that someone capitalized on this opportunity, sees Collingwood as an up and coming area, invested in it, and is, yep, I don't know, hopefully going to make a profit on this. So with time, we shall see what happens to this property. And to conclude this video today, let me know, would you live in Collingwood? Do you want to live in Collingwood? Or do you think personally that Feversham is the new wave, is the new up and coming neighborhood in the north? Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next week, Friday at 7.